we only learn by, you know, trying hard, failing, being unhappy about it, and then, you know, having some kind of aha moment. My name is Fabrice Bernhard. I'm 37, and I'm the co-founder and group CTO of a company called Theodo. So Theodo, we're a software consultancy. So we build software for a large range of clients. So it really goes from small startups to very large organizations. As a co-founder, you're responsible a bit of everything, but you try to, with two co-founders, so we try to share the load. Being the techie one, that means that currently my three big responsibilities are: one, really make sure that the tech quality of what we built is of the highest standard possible. And the second thing is what we call in our industry thought leadership. So try to identify the new innovations, the new trends in technology. Try to identify which ones are useful, which ones are, you know, fads, and which ones are actually game changers for you know, users or workers. And then identify why we can become good at them and why we should be. And then the third thing is really the talent side of things. So managing basically or hiring the best people possible, training them, and making sure the training is good. I mean, I can't train every 300 of them, but you know, working on the quality of the training and managing of the top management to make sure they basically articulate that in the organization. You're expected to be very good at two completely different things. To be very good at tech usually requires to be very passionate about it and really, like, you know, doing a lot of it. And I think it's not a surprise that there's so many introverts in the tech world, because it's something that, you know, you can only start mastering well when you've really put some effort and work into it. So that's all really good. But once you start having responsibilities in the technical world, so when you start becoming a manager or a team leader and you know, all the way up to the CTO, then people start to ask you to also learn about management, to learn more about how people work, how teams work, and how to make them, you know, happy and engaged. Some of the key things you need to know about management is be caring about people, be really interested in people. Which, as I said, if you're more of an introvert personality, so you enjoy being on your own and you actually are, you know, and being in a group or actually leading a group, taking responsibility in the group is not something you're comfortable with, and then it means that everything about management will fundamentally be harder. So it might require quite some dramatic change if you're a very extreme introvert to all of a sudden go to take a management role. I was very geeky. You know, always top of the class. I've always thrived at school. Not that I liked school so much, but I just like learning so much. So, you know, even if school could be a bit annoying or boring sometimes, I really enjoyed learning, and I liked the competition of trying to be good at it. So I've always been quite geeky. The topics I preferred were hard sciences, mostly because I had started learning to code on my dad's computer at a young age. I think I was 11. So by the time I was 17, 18, I was programming games in C++, and therefore kind of seeing the connection. I think that's also something that helped me very much at school, is I could see how what I was learning in math and physics, which for most people at this age seems completely you know, the, what you learn seems completely useless, I could actually use some of that in my hobby, which was programming games. So I think that really helped. You know, I wasn't bad at sports, but I never really enjoyed it. And so I never made any efforts at team sports. You know, I would do, every time I could choose a sport, I would choose climbing or badminton or ping pong or whatever I could do, which didn't involve a team. And I think that's one thing I miss. I miss the experience from a younger age of you know, playing in the group and trying to achieve something as a group, which is basically the essence of being a team. And I think that, you know, instead of doing just climbing and ping pong, I could certainly have, you know, been more involved in handball or whatever team sports was available at the time. One thing I can share, which is very interesting, is I've always been, during my university years, I started becoming very open about my ambition, my goals, rather. I started, you know, sharing with my friends and with peers that, you know, I was interested to become an entrepreneur. And I think that really helped, because then I started having opportunities. So I had a first opportunity with some people from a business background, business school background, came to me and had this idea and wanted me to help build it. It was a complete failure, as much from the tech side as from the teamwork side, I would say. But it was a first try. I think I learned quite a lot from that. And it also, I think, again, because I was very open about the fact that that's what I wanted, you know, stars align much better when you know what you want and people know what you want. Definitely, if you want to achieve things, it's gonna take some learning, and we're you know, human beings are weird animals. We only learn by, you know, trying hard, failing, being unhappy about it, and then, you know, having some kind of aha moment when I thought, actually, you know, that's how I should have done it. So unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be any easy way into becoming successful at what you're trying to learn or to achieve. I was a big fan of Bill Gates. As you can see, he was, at the time, he was still looking quite geeky. This is actually fascinating, because it was written in 93 or 94. And it tells you of how amazing Bill Gates is, and wondering whether he's going to be still there for a few more years. And this is just before Windows 95 came out.